Alright, so this is going to be my first gaming video. This is my Xbox home screen for my Xbox One. And four of these games shown here that I play a lot include Snowrunner, Crossout, Forza Horizon 4, and Forza Motorsport 7. So here, we're going to look at Snowrunner. This is basically an off-road truck simulation game where you could drive in snow, dirt, mud, water, basically anywhere. And, you know, you can haul all kinds of cargoes and trailers and even customize your own trucks. And it's really, really fun. And it really, really challenges you and really tests your mind. So you can figure out what you think is the best route to complete your jobs and your missions and all that. And it's very, very interesting. Like, this game includes real-life licensed trucks, and the customization options is just limitless. And in the future, I'm really hoping that there will be console mods coming in here for Xbox and PlayStation, so that means that the PC community that makes those mods will finally transfer those to the consoles, and hopefully by the next phase or so with the DLCs. So here's SnowRunner. This is the main menu screen. I'll wait for that to load a little bit. Okay. And now we're gonna go to continue. And here's the one of the loading screens. This is where I'm currently stationed. This is in Taimar, Russia. And you can have all kinds of jobs and stuff in here. Like, you can complete different missions and you can unlock different trucks. And you could do basically a lot of different tasks here. And there's a lot of different terrains and elevations and locations that can really test out your driving skills. And as you can see on the loading screen, there's a lot of these factoids that come up on this side here. It really teaches you different things about the trucking industry. It's pretty interesting. And it really gives you all these facts that some of you may not have even heard of in the trucking industry. And so, here is my dream truck, the 5-ton, known as the A&K Mark 38 in-game. This is actually based off of the real-life M939 series 5-ton 6x6 truck from the U.S. military. But we're not going to be here for the challenge that I'm going to show you. So what I'm going to do here is that I'm going to press the X button, and then it will disappear into storage. And so now I'm going to go to my global map. And so these are the different maps that you can drive in. So this is here is in Taimar, Russia. And so far I've unlocked the Drowned Lands, which is where you start off at. And then I've also unlocked the Quarry. And I have yet to unlock Zimnogorsk and Rift, which are other regions in here as well. And also in Russia is the Kola Peninsula, with the two regions known as Lake Kovd and Amandra, both of which I've completed. It took a really, really long time to complete, but I finally managed to pull it off. And so also, aside from Russia, we also have America, including Alaska, which is in the northern parts of the states, actually the very northmost part, right near Canada, actually. And so here we have the maps of Northport, Mountain River, Pedro Bay, and White Valley. And in Northport and White Valley, I have garages where I can store some of my trucks. Whereas in Pedro Bay and Mountain River do not have garage areas. So if you have your truck stranded out there, you may as well recover it to either the Northport garage or White Valley garage. And right over here in Michigan, this is where you basically start off in the game. This is basically where your tutorial is. And you start off in the garage area of Black River and Smithville Dam, that also has a garage. And you can also go to Drummond Island and Island Lake, both of which do not have a garage. But there's all kinds of different tasks and stuff to complete. In fact, this recent update that came out, there's a few new tasks that have been added to these maps. So I have yet to do those later on, but I've completed most of the tasks and contests and contracts here in Michigan. And so, without further ado, we're gonna go ahead and go on to the Black River Garage. So right here, this is Black River in Michigan. This is where you start off at in SnowRunner. And as you can see, these are two trucks that you unlock at the very start of the game, which you can see the Chevrolet CK1500 full-size pickup truck right there. It's a regular cab and it's got a step-side bed on it. It's basically the predecessor of the Silverado. And next to it is the heavy-duty GMC MH9500 Detroit diesel. And you can get that very early on in the game too. And here's another truck that you get in this map as well, which you unlock at the garage. This is the International Fleet Star, but we're not gonna use this for our challenge. So we're gonna put that in our storage. I'm gonna open the storage. And then right here, you could store all your trucks in here. You can have as many trucks as you want and you can store them all here. So what we're gonna do for this challenge is we're gonna use the ANK Mark 38, AKA the M923 5-ton from the US Army, also known as my dream truck. And I actually, believe it or not, really do want this truck in real life. I mean, who doesn't want a six-wheel drive monster that you can drive daily on the streets? That you can, like, basically go anywhere in the world with? I mean, seriously, this thing is beautiful. It's a monster. And I heard these trucks are easy to work on, plus their maintenance is very cheap and affordable, and you can buy these in real life from, like, government auction sites, and I believe the prices can go from, like, $10,000 all the way up to $20,000, depending on the condition and the mileage and the parts that it has and stuff like that. And it's really, really interesting. And what really amazes me is that even though the size of this truck is massive with these 53-inch tires that it has, it's still street legal. And that really makes me happy. And so this one comes with super single tires. This is made for recommendedly going for off-road driving. But here, unlike real life, you can customize your trucks in any way you want. And now there's a lot of various modifications. Now these engine codes are not real, like the names are not real, but the engines sound like they do in real life. So this one has a Cummins diesel, which this one can either have an 8.3 liter turbo Cummins making 240 horsepower and about 760 foot-pounds of torque. I believe that one's called the 6CTA, or it can have the 14 liter naturally aspirated Cummins, and that one does not have a turbo. That one makes 250 horsepower, but slightly less torque, I believe, I think at around 685 foot-pounds. But I mean, it's pretty decent, but 250 horsepower, but 685 torque, I don't think is much. But if I were to get one of these trucks in real life, I would definitely swap this Cummins engine with a Caterpillar engine, hopefully a Caterpillar 3406B diesel engine, which makes 425 horsepower and between 1500 and 1800 foot-pounds of torque. And that's a hell of a lot more powerful than compared to this naturally aspirated Cummins that this one has. And this one can't really be tuned as much as the Caterpillar, which is kind of a bummer because, you know, 250 horses, there's not much you can do in a 20,000 pound truck. I mean, this thing, I believe, weighs over 20,000 to 23,000 pounds in real life. And that's pretty heavy. And that much power and torque, I'm not sure can barely move this. So, but that's kind of what, like, I'm debating on if I were to get this in real life. But, you know, it's a really big debate and stuff. But anywho, these are the engines that you can buy. The first one is the A12V780, which is basically the stock engine. And Once you increase in engine power, your power to weight ratio will go up. That's basically graded into these statistics right below on the bottom. So if you see the name of the truck, known as the A&K Mark 38 in the off-road class. So the power to weight ratio is at A+. However, if I go to the A12V 850 TTA engine, the power to weight goes to an S rating, whereas the durability goes to an A rating. Although, here's the catch. The more powerful the engine, the more it's going to consume diesel fuel. So the fuel consumption goes down, in this case, from a B- to a C+. So it goes down a little bit in fuel consumption. And mind you that this truck drinks a lot of diesel fuel pretty quickly. And it's got a pretty tiny fuel tank. In this case, around 200 liters, which equates to around 53 gallons, which is what I have it at. So that's not a lot of fuel, and it goes through it pretty quick. So it's recommended for using this truck on short haul missions and regional haul jobs and stuff like that, or scouting in general, which this is actually really good at. And here we go down to the top of the line, which is known as the Westline V12 M900 engine. The power to weight goes to an S+ rating, whereas the durability goes to an A rating, and still the fuel consumption is at a C+. So other than that, like, I do keep the stock engine because, like, you know, the A+ rating, it's actually respectable, believe it or not, and it actually is pretty quick and fast. So I'm actually going to keep it that way. And here the transmission, this is very important. So what this does is that this provides a range of gears for you to select when you go off-roading or just driving in general. Now, please note that this is an automatic transmission, but you can switch into low gear manually, which can help you traverse off-road terrain much easier. So the balance transmission, that's basically the stock transmission. I don't really have that installed now, but that has the best fuel economy and is basically your standard transmission with a 5-speed gearbox and all that. Now, high range, this is a bit different. This actually increases your fuel mileage a little bit more, and this has a lot more gears in your transmission. I'm not sure if I'm correct on this, but I believe I saw this truck with this transmission once, and I believe it had around 8 gears in this transmission. Now, that's basically the same amount of gears as in my real-life Chevrolet Corvette C7 Stingray. That has an 8-speed transmission in it. So, believe it or not, the high-range gearbox is an 8-speed transmission. And but here, this is the one that I use. This is for off-road. This is the off-road gearbox. What this does is that it provides high and low gears for traversing off-road terrain much easier. So unlike the standard balance transmission, this one has a low plus gear and a low minus gear for going in different low gear speeds for traversing off-road terrain much quicker than you would with a standard balance transmission. Now, for the suspension, what you go with, if you do stock, then you have to get smaller tires. So I chose the Ray suspension, which gave me the option to use bigger tires. So if you have a raised suspension, you can traverse terrain a lot easier, and you can put bigger tires on your truck, which I think look better and will handle much better on uneven terrain. And now the most important modification that you need for your trucks is the tire modification. Now, these have various different sizes and classes of tires, and so these could be bought for various prices, and they have different tire performances. So here, this truck has dualies for on highway usage. So these are highway spec tires. These ones are 47 inches. This is known as UHD1, UHD2, and UHD3. Now, please note they have different tread patterns with these different number codes right there on the tires. So as you can see, the tread patterns are a little bit different. And these are dualies, whereas these are like your average semi-truck 18-wheeler tractor-trailer type tires and stuff. And now, with my race suspension, I can go to 51 inches. These are the biggest you can get on this truck. They're not exactly 52, but they're close enough to what you get in real life. But these are basically the 51-inch dualies that you can get for the highway tires. Now, please know that these are very, very terrible for going in mud or snow or dirt. And these are more recommended for going on asphalt paved roads and stuff. So if you want to go off-roading, these tires do not do anything for you. So if you're more of a highway driver, then go for these tires. And so the tread patterns are the same as on both these tires. There's just the size difference is a little bit different. So now going to all-terrain, these ones are better for off-roading, and they do decently well on-road as well. And these are also dualies with 47 inches and 51 inches. These ones are known as the UAD 1, 2, and 3 for the 47s. And for the 51s, they're the same UAD 1, 2, and 3 tread patterns as well. And these are also dualies. And now for off-road, this is where you can get the super singles as well. So these are the super single off-road tires that this truck comes with standard. It also comes with a tire pressure inflation system. So basically what that means is that this truck can inflate its tires on demand. So that can really help when you're traversing off-road terrain. And if you want higher or lower pressure, depending on the terrain that you're on, you can switch that by default. But unfortunately, you don't really tweak with tire pressures in this game, so the tire pressure remains the same. But however, you get the point. So these are the super singles, which these ones are the 47 inches. This is known as the ANKO1. Now, aside from the super singles, you can also get off-road dualies. Now, these are the 47-inch UOD1, UOD2, and UOD3. And now, we'll go to the 51-inch super singles. This is what I have, and this is what I prefer when going on uneven terrain, mostly for off-roading and stuff. This is the ANKO1 for the 51-inch super singles, and same for the 51-inch dualies. You get the UOD1, UOD2, and UOD3 for the off-road dualies. And now for chained, these are the chain dualies. So this is with all chains, and you want these tires for traversing through thick ice and very heavy snow. So these steel chains that are wrapped around your tires, that'll really give you all that extra traction when you're traversing ice and snow. Now, these are also 47 inches tall. These are basically the all-terrain style tires with the steel snow chains on them. So it's also the dualies, but notice that the steel chains are on one of the dually tires instead of all of them. But however, the all chains means that it's on the super single front tires and the dually rear tires. So the 47-inch UAD3 all chains for this one. And now for the UAD 47-inch rear chains, that means that the chains are only on the dually tires, whereas the super singles are just all-terrain. There's no chains on the front tires. And what I used in Alaska and the Kola Peninsula are the 51-inch UAD3 all-chain dualies. That really, really helped me out very well in Alaska and the Kola Peninsula with its snowy ice and snow areas. And it'll really get you out of that trouble. And also, they have the 51-inch UAD3 rear chains, with the chains being only on the 51-inch dualies as well. So those are all your tire options. And now another important option to get is the winch. And you need this if your truck is stuck or crashed. So if you're trying to get to like a different area, or if you want to get out of a sticky situation, what you do is that you use the winch, and this will go on to trees or even other trucks or heavy objects, and you can pull yourself using this electric motor-powered winch, and hopefully it'll get you out of trouble. And so I currently have the stock medium and extended medium. So basically it's like an extended rope length and an advanced medium. So this combines the extended rope with an improved electric motor. And here's the high power medium, which is basically a more powerful electric motor winch. But I'll get the advanced medium at some point soon with both the more powerful motor and the extended rope. But the stock medium actually does pretty decent for its power. And now for spare tires, you can get that if you want. That's an option if one of your tires blows out, but that's okay for me. So I've never blown a tire in this truck, so these tires are pretty reliable, so I don't see a need for a spare tire. Now, for those of you who love to swim, did you know that you can also install a snorkel on your truck? What this means is that this tall stack here captures extra air when your truck is swimming through water. So it's like an extra air intake. And so the air goes right in through that air intake snorkel, so your engine will still work and it won't get damaged when you're in deep water. I really like that feature. And if you're a swimmer, you'd probably understand what I'm talking about. So, you know, if humans can have snorkels, so can trucks. And I say it looks pretty cute as well, but it's very crucial when fording through deep water. And you can have different styles of snorkels. See, this is a tall front facing snorkel or a tall flat cap snorkel. And this is the stock snorkel, which is kind of puny in my opinion, but they're all the same height. I like this one better because it's got a different look to it than the other two. And so that's all the customization. Well, that's all the upgrade, excuse me. But you can also do visuals here, like exhaust modifications for your diesel exhaust stacks. This is a wedge cap, or the muzzle, which is what I have, heat shielded, and this is the stock, which it already comes with, miscellaneous, which this means you can have all your rooftop modifications. So here, I can have a chain, I can have a cage beacon light, tri-square beacons, small parking lights, which is what I have, an external horn, or a twin horn, which is what I have, and beacons and fog lights, which I have right there, or roof fog lights, whichever one you want. And front bumpers, this will really increase your durability if you're really messed up or if you come into a lot of front-end collisions and stuff. So the bumpers range from the heavy duty, which is what I have, or a heavy duty pipe, trapism, kind of like a trapezoid style, hinged, single bar, and that's the stock bumper, which is really puny and doesn't provide like any protection at all. So I chose the heavy duty right here since it sticks out the farthest and it looks like it provides the most protection. Plus it already has a built-in winch and lights, so it's got its perks. And so on the front side, I have these sideboard thresholds, which are basically the step stools so you can get in. It's right next to the diesel exhaust tank and diesel tank right there. And it's right below the battery box. And right up here, I put in a chrome cap visor, and it also has beacons on it as well. And now the rims, since I have the super singles, this is known as the A and K rims, which are the stock rims that it came with. And so that's all the customization for the visuals. Now you can also change the color of your truck as well. Now this is the exact same military style color that it came with, and you can make it any color you want. This is the red color, so I have it colored in the same color as my Chevrolet Corvette Stingray real life car. You can also have it tan or beige, or a darker shade of that, or orange, teal, yellow, gold, dark green, dark blue, light blue, aqua blue, turquoise. I think that's a midnight blue, and that's got to be like a in-between blue or like an indigo style blue or purple, a lighter purple. That looks like a really faded blue, I believe. Or even pink, for those of you who love pink stuff. Black, gray, and here's a different army camo look as well. This one's blue and white, whereas this one is a mixture of a desert-looking style or a forestry-looking style. It's got black, brown, and gray on it as a mixture. And here's all white. That's another one as well. And here's different army camo patterns. This one's like I believe this one's more of a Desert Storm style. And here is a bit of like an aqua style. I think this one's like a light blue with the green and the black on it. And this one's like a green style, like a forest kind of looking style. It's kind of weird in my opinion. But yeah, those are all the colors. So I'm gonna keep the red in honor of my Corvette, because it looks like that. Okay, and also something new for this customization is interior accessories. So all you have are these poker gambling style cards that, you know, that you play in like blackjack or poker or a lot of card games and stuff with gambling. So you can buy either a card of clubs, diamonds, hearts, or spades. I chose hearts because why not? And stickers, you can put right above that, which I have the Freedom Bird, because basically this truck is made to secure freedom. And it's basically a freedom fighter, because, you know, it's made for the military. Military is used to protect freedom, you know? That's why. And here's other styles as well, known as Take My Winch and Light My Fire. Here, I'm gonna get my controller on there. Hold on. Controller kind of blacked out a little bit. I'm using a wired controller with a wire on it, and it's also detachable. Sometimes it loses signal sometimes. So here's the other stickers. So this one is Take My Winch. That's kind of cute. Light My Fire. Holy Stepney. Your Adventure. Apologetic. Off-Road Club. Although I believe that's in Russian. I don't really understand what that means. If you're Russian, you'd probably understand what that means, but I really don't. So correct me if I'm wrong, but if you're Russian, then you can probably read that. So here's another one. This is Park Wherever I Want, because, hey, when you own a military truck, that's what you do. And Your Own Way, which is basically a stop sign or like a non-entry sign with Russian characters on it. So if you're Russian, then you could probably read that. So, and that's all the customization. And so the mission that we're actually going to do is one of my personal favorites and one of the easiest to do. And so here's my driving screen. And so, as you can see, on the bottom right corner, in this case, my bottom left corner, that is my fuel gauge, and it shows you how much fuel that you have. In this case, I have 53 gallons, and it also shows your parameters of your tires, your fuel capacity, your engine, your transmission, and your suspension in case if it gets damaged. And if I press up on the D-pad, your functions open up, which you can either attach a trailer, start your engine, or change your truck if it's nearby, or recover it if your truck is either out of fuel or crashed. And if you have cargo in your truck, you can remove it. And so, on my right-hand corner of the screen, and in this case, the left-hand corner on the video, that is my gear selector on the very bottom, which I'm currently in automatic mode, And if I use the C-stick and go down, I can go into low reverse gear. And in automatic, I can go in either forward or reverse. This is a four-speed transmission, as you can see. So this is four forward gears and one reverse. Then again, this is the off-road spec transmission. And now I go to neutral, so I don't move anywhere. I just rev the hell out of my engine, and that's it. And now if I go to high, this is the high range version of this, but unfortunately, this is a very, very low high gear. Like, the truck does not accelerate very fast in high gear. It's actually very slow in high gear. So if you want to go faster, then go to automatic mode. And this is more for like the high range transmission, which has more gears. This truck goes much faster in this gear when you have the high range transmission, but we're going to use the off-road transmission today. And right here, this is low gear. This is basically provides all torque to all the wheels of your transmission for your gears to go through, and all your tires turn at the exact same speed when in low gear mode. And so this is low plus, this is low normal, and this is low minus. But please remind you that this goes very slow in low gear, but you need that for traction when you want to traverse various off-road terrains that are almost impossible to go through. So if you're stuck in automatic mode, it's best to shift to low gear so you can traverse your off-road terrains much easier and you can start moving with ease. So this really does help. So in this case, we're gonna go back to automatic mode and my handbrake is on, so I'm gonna press my B button here. Now you can't see below that, but below the handbrake, I have my all-wheel drive always on and my differential lock always on. So this is a six-wheel drive or a 6x6. So all six wheels drive the truck and the differential lock is permanent. So all torque is provided evenly through all six wheels through the permanent locking differential. And that's how it works. And now we're gonna start driving toward our destination. And here we started up here. And that's the Cummins at idle. And here it is under load and revving. Almost sounds like a straight pipe, pretty cool. But it revs even more when underway. So now here we go. Now you can see out of my exhaust, there's a lot of diesel fuel spewing out of there. We call that rolling coal. That's basically the really, really puffy black smoke that you see these diesel engines spew out. But due to recent emission laws, you know, most trucks don't do that as much. All these emission stuff that we put in all these trucks. Although that really, you know, hinders the horsepower and torque, and it really quiets the engine, which in my opinion is not a good thing, because I love for diesel engines to be loud and all that. Which in case, this Cummins is very, very loud, and it does not have all this emissions crap on it. So the military doesn't really care about that. So that's what I like about it. You know, they want a loud, reliable diesel engine that will get them to and from any situation desirable. And plus, the emission stuff really damages and harms the engine as well, and it really hinders its performance. So here's our mission that we're doing. We're at a nearby farm, which is right across the street from the garage, just after that turn right there. And so, at this farm, this is one of our loading stations. And so, in this case, I open cargo management here, and the only loading cargo that I can put on here is consumables, which are in these wooden crates. And basically, these are stuff like food items or medical items or stuff like that. But in this case, this is food items. So I'm gonna haul up two of these into my sideboard bed. automatically. So when I press A to auto load, they automatically come in there like magic. But it doesn't really work like that in real life. But to be more realistic, if you want to load and unload your cargo manually, you can either have a crane on your truck and you can load the cargo right there manually, just like that, if you want to simulate more real life conditions. But this is just a game, so you can auto load your cargo if you want, or you can manually load it if you desire. So it's all on the driver and their types of loading and unloading for cargo. And so right over there in front of us is the challenge we're going to be doing with this consumable cargo that we have loaded in our bed. And so this is the contest that we'll be doing. This is called food delivery. So the description says, Dyson Diesel's regular food shipment has been delayed for days. And if we don't get some grub over to those oil men soon, the rumbling in their bellies will be louder than the drilling. So in this case, what we're going to do is that we're going to drive from this farm all the way to a nearby drilling rig. It's actually not too far from here, about a quarter mile away from here, or a little bit less and stuff. It's actually really, really easy to get to. Now, here's the tricky part. Now, with these interactions here, you have to avoid including recovering your truck if you crash. But if you crash, then you may have to recover your truck anyway. And if you change your truck or if you go to your garage, then the contest will not count and you will have to start again. And another parameter that you have to meet is that you cannot exceed 200 damage points. If you exceed 200 damage points, then you will fail the mission as well. Now, if you complete the mission, you can come in a various placing of positions here. Now, to make things more challenging, this mission puts you against the clock. So you have to race against the clock to get to a certain destination. In this case, we're starting from the farm and going all the way to the nearby drilling rig. And so we have to complete this task in less than 6 minutes if we want to get gold. But if you still want to complete the challenge, but if you basically complete it in any time you want, or if you just finish whenever, basically if you finish over 9 minutes, then you get bronze, or in third place, with 1,050 in-game dollars and 100 in-game XP. And if you come in second place, which is colored silver, you come in at around 9 minutes or less, and you receive about 1,800 in-game dollars with about 170 in-game XP. Now, if you want gold or in first place, which is what I actually have, once you achieve gold, you get 3,700 in-game dollars with 340 in-game XP. Doesn't look like much, but you can get this mission done very, very quickly. And so I basically do this mission. So what this does is that you can do this multiple times as you want, and you can really grind and grind and grind and get a lot of in-game money in here. So you can buy the trucks and the trailers and the upgrades for your trucks that you want very, very quickly. Now, this is basically one of the easiest, if not the easiest way to grind and make a lot of money in this game. And so, that's my current best time, 3 minutes and 26 seconds. I'm not entirely sure if we'll beat it, but I'm going to show you the demonstration on what we will actually be doing. So, but before we begin, I'm going to pull up the map here. This is the whole entire map of the region of Black River, Michigan. So, if you don't know where you're going, this is where we are right here. If you're not sure where you want to go, so what we need to do is that we need to go all the way over here to this drilling site. Now, before we do, I'm going to show you what you can do to find your way if you're either stuck or you're lost and you have no idea where to go, if you're trying to map out your route on what you think is the best way to complete various missions. So where we're going, this is a very easy thing you could do. Just press the right trigger, in this case, the accelerator button. So what this does is that this creates an imaginary destination dot in front of you and your distance that you have to reach it. And you can apply this multiple times and make an imaginary route that you can follow, and it's only visible to you. So you can see it when you go along. This is basically your navigation route. And so I know this route by heart because I've been doing it for a long, long time. So I keep mapping out these destination blips along the way. So this is basically where we'll be going. So you can do this as many times as you want until you can get to your destination, which is exactly what we're doing here. And this is where our destination is, right here. And so, without further ado, we're going to go ahead and start the contest. And now the clock is ticking, and here we go. And here there's my first destination blip, and I'm going to be hitting more of those as I go along. And so we're just exiting the farm, and we're going up this little hill here. And this truck really gets through mud and dirt very easily. I mean, this really is a proven off-road monster. It really is. I mean, this could tackle almost anything you could throw at it. I mean, who needs a Jeep or any 4x4 when you can have a 6x6 like this? I mean, how cool is that? Okay, so we exited the farm, so now we're going to hit this asphalt tarmac stretch here. I'm going to go around this corner. We're going to pass this diesel fuel station, but we don't need any fuel, so we're okay with it. And so we're going to go around this turn here. Ignore that speed limit sign. You can go as fast as you want here. And so now we're going to go back on dirt. And now we're over a minute of the time for the clock. And so right up here, we're going to make a pretty hard left-hand turn. It's a very, very sharp left. So you might want to be very careful on how you execute this turn. So we're just going to turn really sharp and just nail that turn right there. And now we're back on the tarmac. We're going downhill a little bit, so we got to be a little bit careful on how we approach this. Now, this truck is a little unstable, so if you're on uneven ground or if you make a turn too fast, you will flip over really, really quickly. And you don't have a winch to recover, so you have to be very careful on what you do. So you have to be very, very, very precise on where you steer your truck. So keep that in mind. So we're going to go up this little dirt stretch here. We're approaching the 2-minute mark. It's kind of slowing a little bit, but it gets through it pretty quickly. So here, we're going to go up this little tiny ramp here. It's best to hit it at a little bit of an angle. In this case, I'm going to have to back up because I kind of hit it at a little bit of a straight angle, so I had to back out of it a little bit. And so now we're going over a little bit right over here, going over this left-hand turn. And now we have to go over this bridge. Now, this is a wooden bridge. Now, you have to hit this really straight, because if you have either half your wheels on it or half your wheels off, you will flip over and plunge straight into the river, which is something you don't want to do. You have to make sure that all your wheels are straight and are going straight ahead over the bridge, and we just crossed the bridge. And so now we're approaching some deep mud. So in this case, we're going to activate low gear mode. We're going to go in low plus, so it's a little bit quicker. And now we are approaching the drilling site. Got some deep mud a little bit in here. So gonna let the low gear mode go to work a little bit more. Then we're going to switch back into auto mode. And then we have reached our destination right here. Cargo management. And then we get our reward. And that really beautiful D minor electric guitar track plays after you complete this contest. And this shows you the time that you completed it in, and the money that you got, as well as the XP that you got. So in this case, we got 3,700 in-game dollars and 340 XP. And right above there is the profile balance. So now I have 64,750 in-game dollars as of now. And now, since we're done, we could just recover back to our garage, and our truck magically appears back in the garage, fully repaired and fully refueled, and we can start all over again. And you can do these missions as many times as you want, which is the great idea of it. So if you're doing like a regular contract or a task, you only do those once. But when it comes to a contest, you can do that multiple times. You can do that as many times as you want, actually. Now, that's actually really cool. It really tests your skills and your driving capabilities and pushes them to the limits. And it actually adds a lot of the fun factor in there, too. And now, this truck just never lets me down. Minus its drinking problem and its tippy problem. I mean, those are like the two things that I'm hoping to fix with it. Because, like, when console mods come out, I'm hoping to give it a larger fuel tank and hoping to maybe give it a more stable suspension and maybe different wheels and tires and hopefully different body add-ons, because it does not have any body add-ons at the moment, just the sideboard bed that it comes with. So I'm really hoping that would change, as well as give it a different diesel engine, hoping maybe the Caterpillar 3406B, which that makes 425 horsepower. That's a lot more powerful than compared to this 250 horsepower Cummins. And there is a truck in this game that does have the Caterpillar 3406B as a standard engine. That is the Ford CLT9000, which is basically a heavy-duty cab-over truck made by Ford. They don't make it anymore, but it looks really cool among cab-over enthusiasts. And the Caterpillar diesel engine that it's got really sounds very good. And I'm really hoping to swap that in this, hopefully at some point soon. And it should give it a better power-to-weight rating. And I'm hoping different fuel consumption, hopefully less. So we'll have to wait and see on that. But that's only when the console mods come out. So that's hoping to come out very soon. Because, like, the PC computer community has been modding these trucks and even maps in this game a lot. So they do a lot of crazy stuff to some of these trucks, and we're hoping as console users to get these as well, hopefully in the future. And so, now, I'm really hoping, like, you know, I've really grown to like this truck because, like, of how massive it is, and the fact that it's a 6x6, and that you can still drive it legally on the road, like, on highways and even city streets, just like that. It's really cool. Now, a big debate that, you know, I ask a lot of truck drivers is, you know, whether if it's best to use super single tires or dually tires. Because, like, a lot of truck drivers say dualies can haul more weight and all that and give you better traction, whereas super singles are lighter and provide better fuel economy. Now, both arguments are actually correct. However, when it comes to off-roading, a lot of off-road truckers say super singles do a lot better than dualies. And a lot of other truckers say that when super single tires blow out, then you're pretty much stranded until you can make a tire repair or when a tow truck comes to tow it to a repair shop. Whereas if you have dually tires and one of the dually tires blows out, you can still drive your truck pretty decently well for a little bit, but not as much, but at least you'd still drive it a bit. But then again, it's a big debate. So as long as these tires are massive, I'm happy with it. And I would like to change the wheels because I would like for it to have different wheels and maybe different tires as well. And definitely more body add-ons to make it more versatile and more useful. As well as the Caterpillar 3406B diesel engine, which I would actually would want for that to be for this truck in real life if I were to buy this. Now, you can actually buy these trucks in real life on government auction sites. Now, that's really interesting. So basically, you have to bid on these trucks. And I've never done it before, but it looks really interesting. And like, I've met a lot of guys that have these trucks, and I've seen some of these at car meets, which is really cool. And you can buy these, as I mentioned before, from like less than $10,000 to less than $20,000, depending on the mileage, condition, and the parts content, and all that. And the maintenance on these trucks is very cheap, and all that. And the parts are readily available. You can get parts for these anywhere. And, you know, plus, they can serve you, like, for various needs and purposes, and all that. Like, it's not just a strictly military truck anymore. It could also be a farm truck, hell, even a fire truck, or just a civilian pickup truck, you know, or just a, you know, just an off-roading toy, you know? But, like, what I would change about it if I were to have one of these in the future is I would replace the sideboard bed with a dry van box, as you've seen on delivery trucks, with a side door on the side of it, with a lift gate on the rear, and I would want that divided into two bays, where I'd want one of the bays being partly like an RV, whereas it would have like a bed and a bathroom and a kitchen in that area, whereas the second bay would be for storage, as well as for tools for working on cars and all kinds of different things. And as well as for hauling various parts and cargo and goods, etc., and all that. But, you know, but I want this, you know, just to be personal for me. I don't want this to be for hire. Now, some say, now this is a very big debate that still confuses me, that I'm still trying to get answers to. I don't know if you actually need a CDL for this truck. That means it's a commercial driver's license for driving big 18-wheeler trucks, basically heavy-duty trucks like this that are somewhat over 26,000 pounds of a gross vehicle weight, which this is, which is required by law. However, there are exceptions to this law, which some guys say that you can drive this without a CDL if you register this as an RV or a farm truck or as an antique truck, which it basically is. This truck was made, I believe, from the 1980s through the early 1990s and stuff like that. And it's very easy to work on and parts are readily available and stuff. Or, you know, you can also title it the option to not have it for hire. And but that's, I think that, I'm not sure if that's a difficult thing to do. I'm not entirely sure, but this one, I don't want to be for hire. I would want to be for personal use and all that. Like, I would want just this truck for myself, and I feel like it would be fun, like, you know, just to have as a project to go along my Corvette Stingray, which I currently have, to have this as my dream truck, and a secondary daily slash project to my current dream car that I have. And, you know, a truck would definitely go well with it, you know, like. But then again, you know, it's a big debate. So, but all these mods that I'm thinking about with, you know, the van box and all that and the different tires and the different diesel engine and stuff, I also need a different transmission for it as well. That would definitely cost a lot, but the truck itself, like either 20 grand or less, I mean, that would seem like a bargain. But when it comes to modding this whole thing, that'd be a different story. Now, but then again, you know, it's a really big debate, and I'm not really sure how long it would be if I were to get this, or if I were to get this, but it's what I've been having in my head and stuff like that, and I'm still doing my research and trying to figure out, you know, different options and, you know, potentials and possibilities for this truck and stuff like that. And, you know, like, I don't know, like, I'm hoping, like, if, like, maybe in the future would come around, like, if I were to get a little bit more money and stuff, or, you know, if I were to save up and all that, and if I were to maybe enlist in a government auction site, then, you know, go for one of these, you know, maybe why not? But, you know, right now, you know, it's still a big debate, because there's a lot of factors that happen and go on if you want to buy any type of truck, including if it's a military truck like this, and depending on whatever you want to use it for. So it really, really gives you a lot of questions and stuff and debates with what you want to do with that. And these trucks are still in use today. Like, they're still roaming the battlefields today in many armies, including the U.S. Army, which this one was based off of. And also, this truck has been exported to various other countries to serve in our allies' armies and even as civilian vehicles with allied countries as well, which is actually pretty interesting. And I've seen some of these at car meets, as well as Humvees and Hemets as well. And these military trucks are really, really cool. And, like, I've heard that they're easy to work on, and they go forever. And, you know, they almost never break down, and they're super reliable. They're built to last, and they just never die. They keep going. And, you know, with the proper hands of a skilled tuner or a mechanic, you know, these trucks will last a lifetime if properly maintained and properly tuned and stuff. And that's why I really like these, because, like, you know, why waste, you know, say $100,000 or maybe like $70,000 or $80,000 on, say, a top of the line Ford F-150, Chevrolet Silverado, or Dodge Ram with street tires, street suspension, no off-road bits, no off-road suspension, no off-road tires, and, you know, no, like, readily available off-road parts that would break easily, and, you know, like, and just your whole suspension stuff would be completely destroyed and stuff, and so will your running gear and stuff. I mean, why waste your money on that when you can get one of these for much less, and that is proven for off-road performance and lots of abuse? I mean, this is really, I mean, a great buy. It really is. I mean, if you're looking for a 6x6 as a project, or as an antique, or just as an all-around off-road monster, then yeah, go for this one, the 5-ton. Now, it's called the 5-ton because that means that it was made to haul 5 tons of weight off-road and 10 tons of weight on-road. And that's how it's got its name. Now, please note that this is not a deuce and a half. This is much bigger and heavier than a deuce and a half. The deuce and a half is also a 6x6, which is also with dually tires, but however, that has a multi-fuel engine which means it is either fueled by either gas or diesel, but it runs best on diesel, but it is a lot weaker and much less powerful than compared to this. And it doesn't really last as long as this. But that depends on the owner, because, like, there's a lot of those deuce and a half owners out there and stuff, and I actually did see one of those deuce and a halves at a car meet once, and it had the multi-fuel engine in it, and the owner actually let me start it up one time. It was actually really cool. But the deuce and a half, that's a medium duty, basically. So you can drive that without a CDL, no problem. Now, with this, that's a whole different story due to the weight being over 26,000 pounds of gross vehicle weight. And also, this has air brakes. Now, some say that you need a CDL if it has air brakes, which a lot of guys recommend. But then again, you know, if you're using this for private use, which is what I would intend to do, instead of higher, then you may not need a CDL. But then again, correct me if I'm wrong, but, you know, there's a lot of various ways that, you know, could be around that. But I'm not an expert when it comes to, like, you know, the trucking industry in terms of licensing and, you know, what you can and can't do to your trucks and stuff like that. And I'm not an expert in, say, you know, the licensing part of that, like the CDLs and stuff like that. I have no idea what exemptions there are to that when it comes to these. So if you're in the trucking industry, correct me if I'm wrong, but I'm not entirely sure if you actually need a CDL for this truck, even though it's a heavy duty, but you're using it for private personal usage and it's basically an antique, or you know, you can register as an RV if you want, as well as you know, not for hire and all that, but you know, but for those of you who are truck drivers, please let me know what you think, and you know, because then again, I don't know much about that, so please help me with that and correct me if I'm wrong. So I would like your thoughts and opinions on that. But in the future of my life, hopefully, I'm really hoping to maybe get my hands on one of these in the future. I don't know if I will or when, but you know, it's as of right now, it's a dream that I'm having. You know, it's a dream like a goal that, you know, I'm really wanting to accomplish. I'm not sure when or if I'll achieve it, but who knows? Only time and God will tell, so we'll have to wait and see. But yeah, that's SnowRunner for you. And, you know, it basically simulates real-life off-road truck driving. So if you're into driving trucks on rough terrain, whether it be dirt, mud, or snow, or even water, hauling all kinds of goods and all that to various different locations and elevation changes and terrains, then this game is for you. And SnowRunner is out for Xbox One, which is what this is, as well as PlayStation 4 and PC as well. And now I'm hoping for us to get console mods in the future, which those are currently on PC, but if they come to console, that would be awesome. Now, I would do a lot of stuff to this truck as well as many other trucks I have in the game as well. I'm really hoping for that, so it's one of these things that I'm really, really looking forward to with this game and all that. So then again, this has been SnowRunner. Please let me know what you think, and thanks for watching, and I might make some more gaming videos like this, maybe with Forza in the future, maybe Crossout, who knows. So I think I might maybe want to try this a little bit more often with this setup. So it looks pretty good. So let me know what you think, and thanks for watching.